And we know many of you would like to help out in any way you can, but what's the best way to donate and make sure you don't become the victim of a scam? The I-Team's Barry Sims continues our team coverage. He's live downtown tonight with some answers for us. Barry?
Well, Stan, that is a question that many people are asking. What can I do to help? But they are also very concerned about giving out contributions because they want to make sure their donations go to the victims. The needs are both urgent and numerous. And it seems the outpouring of care and concern is tremendous.
It's so heartbreaking. I really wish I could do more. Like, I want to hop on a plane and fly over there and say, hey, I'm here to lend a helping hand. Where do you need me?
Jennifer Webster has watched news reports on the devastation in Japan caused by the earthquake and tsunami. She was considering a food or clothing drive. U.S. troops are preparing aid to deliver to the hardest hit areas, but the American Red Cross and other groups suggest anyone willing to help with disaster relief just send money.
We can't accept donations like canned goods, like bottled water, things like that. The reason is because that costs the Red Cross a lot of money to ship those supplies over to Japan and to the affected areas. So it's more cost effective, more efficient, and a better use of the donor's money to just send cash and let the Japanese Red Cross get the supplies they need as they need it.
Donations are being accepted online and by text messaging. The Red Cross says many people in Central Maryland are responding.
A young girl, about 12 years old, called. She had helped during the Haitian earthquake. She wanted to help again. And then on a much larger scale, Constellation Energy has stepped up and offered $50,000 to this relief effort.
A father and son from Randallstown brought in their donations.
You can't imagine the disaster over there. It's just unimaginable. So those people need a lot of help. Every little bit helps.
The Catholic Church in Baltimore is also seeking donations.
Well, our prayers are certainly necessary. This is a time of human solidarity with the Japanese people, regardless of nationality or religion.
Archbishop Edwin O'Brien sent a letter to all 153 local parishes requesting they hold special collections this coming weekend.
All the money will go directly to human need in Japan.
Now, after the 2005 tsunami in Southeast Asia, the Catholic Church in Baltimore raised $2.5 million for relief efforts. And while many are willing to give, consumer protection experts from the Maryland Attorney General's office offer these tips so that you don't get scammed. Beware of fake websites resembling trusted organizations. Don't make cash donations. Use credit cards or checks. And never make checks out to individuals. They should be made out to organizations. Now, for more tips and to find agencies that are working directly with disaster relief, you can go to our website, WBALTV.com. Reporting live from downtown Baltimore, Barry Sims, WBAL-TV 11 News.